The police officer who is charged of rape and misconduct has been laid off without pay. Why Spokane City leaders made the decision and how Nathan Nash can get back on payroll.
Mountain snow showers continue into the weekend, but a break for our lowland elevations. Find out when we're seeing our next chance for snow.
Kentucky's governor is restoring voting rights to 100,000 felons. This morning, we want you to weigh in. Should people convicted of a felony be allowed to vote?
You can't even imagine how much joy it brings to other people.
A Spokane Valley couple loves Christmas. No, really. Check out their front yard. Nearly every inch is covered with decorations.
Up with Krim starts right now with Jen York, Evan Nirani, and Dina Marie McNichol.
Well, the Zags are back in action this weekend. Tomorrow, the men's basketball team will be taking on the Arizona Wildcats.
The Bulldogs are 3-6 all-time against Arizona, but they have won the last two times they played.
I do know they just defeated Washington too, though.
Yes, so I
we'll so see.
I remember the three times that they did lose, I was in college while watching.
You had the bad luck charm thing.
Yes, and always the U of A game was always just what's going to happen this year, and it was between 3 or 4 points every time. So it's always a really good game.
Yeah, we'll be looking forward to that. All right, due to slick road conditions, there is a school delay this morning. Right now, Moses Lake School District is on a 2-hour delay. We'll keep you updated if any more delays come in right here on Up With Krem and on Krem.com. Well, hey, good morning, everyone. It is Friday. We finally made it. It was the weekend is almost
Yay!
Upon us, and for some of us, a long vacation.
That's right. Yeah.
Evan's got a big smile on his face.
I know it's Friday. We're starting off the day too with mainly dry conditions. Just seeing some mountain snow showers that persist into the weekend, but otherwise a mostly dry weekend for the majority of us. Here's the view outside. Of course, still about 2.5 hours before that sun comes up, and with it, we should be seeing actually a lot of the snow already has melted off, and we're going to see the continuation of that process. Us today. We are going to continue with those mountain snow showers. That's what we have on satellite radar right now, is just mainly mountain snow showers. Last night into this morning brought more snow for some regions. Most of us saw just rain, and especially in the Spokane area, that came as just a rainy evening overnight. And then temperatures this afternoon expected to rise to about 40 degrees. Now, a steady cool down comes from about today onward. We've got 41 degrees as that afternoon high. Southwesterly winds all the way through the day in the very low single digits. Cloudy skies, though, are kind of all we're seeing for today. Now, for the weekend, 35 degrees for your Saturday, 32 for Sunday. Sunday's going to be the colder of the 2 days, but it's also going to be the drier of the 2 days. Saturday still shows a chance for a couple snow showers persisting through the area. Otherwise, though, expect most of those snow showers to taper off by the end of the day today. But still, today kind of incorporates that chance for our lowland elevations to pick up on a flurry or two and then see those skies clear out a bit, headed into about the Saturday-Sunday period, and then dry into the beginning of next week. It is just hitting 503 right now. Tim, back to you.
All right, Evan, thank you. Well, the city of Spokane laid off the officer charged with rape and misconduct. Nicole Hernandez is in the newsroom to break down how this is different than being on administrative leave. Nicole, good morning.
And good morning, Tim. So Nathan Nash is now laid off, meaning the city will not be paying him or giving him benefits. Now, this is a change from the administrative leave Nash has been on previously. The decision is not permanent, though. They could still decide to put Nash back on the force. Nash is the officer who was charged with rape after a woman accused him of violating her during an investigation. Now, city spokesperson Marlene Feist said a committee of three people made the decision to lay off Nash. They looked at how severe his crime was, how the crime was related to his everyday work, how the decision would affect public relations, and lastly, how Nash leaving would impact the police department. If a court finds Nash guilty, the city will remove him from the force for good. But if he's found not guilty, the city will reinstate him and do an internal investigation to figure out if he broke any department policies. I'll send things back to you, Tim.
All right, Nicole, thank you. Your morning rush continues now. Happening now, a nationwide search is underway for a mother and her 9-year-old son. Police in Haley, Idaho say Olivia Barks moved to Idaho several months ago with her 3 children, including Logan Barks. She was working on custody arrangements for her children with their father. Those court proceedings wrapped up last week with the dad getting full custody. Barks is believed to have left the state with Logan. A nationwide arrest warrant has been issued for her. Anyone who has seen them are asked to call police, the Haley Police Department, and that number will get you on, we'll get that for you on creme.com. Attorney General Bob Ferguson announced multiple pieces of legislation to combat mass shootings in Washington. Ferguson proposed them three times before, but this is the first time Governor Jay Inslee will join him in requesting it. The first bill wants to limit magazine capacity to 10 rounds. The second proposed bill looks to ban the sale of some semi-automatic or military-style rifles. The final bill would strengthen state rules surrounding ammunition sales. Catholic Charities is taking its first step of many steps to opening a new warming center in Spokane. The warming center at Catholic Charities Holy Names Covenant is intended for families. It would serve about 45 people. This would be the second warming center to open in the city. The other is operated by Jules Helping Hands. It currently serves about 98 people. Well, Spokane just keeps getting better, including one of the best places to start a business. Spokane came in 31st, ranking even higher in specific categories. The city ranked number 6 for entrepreneurship, number 14 for population growth, and number 19 for early stage funding deals. Boise, Portland, and Seattle also ranked among the top 50. Pretty interesting. We all know Spokane's pretty awesome. Well, that's your Morning Rush. More news in less time. Let us know what's happening in your neighborhood by using the hashtag UpWithCrem. The governor of Kentucky vowed during his inaugural address this week to restore voting rights to thousands of people convicted of felonies. Dana Marie is in studio now with more. Dana Marie.
Hi, good morning. So Kentucky just elected a new governor, as you said, Andy Beshear, and he has been busy during his first week in office. Yesterday, he signed an executive order restoring voting rights to over 140,000 men and women convicted of a felony. Kentucky imposes a lifetime ban on voting for convicted felons, one of the most stringent restrictions in the nation. During his inaugural speech, he said, quote, "They deserve to participate in our great democracy. By taking this step, by restoring these voting rights, we declare everyone in Kentucky counts."
We're talking about moms and dads, neighbors and friends, people who have taken on and met one of the greatest challenges that any of us could face. Overcoming the past, becoming contributing members of society here in Kentucky. That's why I believe it's wrong. In fact, I believe it is an injustice that their ability to fully rejoin society by casting a vote on Election Day is automatically denied, regardless of the circumstances of their offense or their good work since serving their sentences.
Each state has different requirements and restrictions. So here in Washington and Idaho, if you were convicted of a felony, your right to vote is restored as long as you're not in prison or in custody of the Department of Corrections, meaning that you're done with parole and probation. In Oregon, once you're released from prison, you can vote, and only two states, Vermont and Maine, allow voting from prison. To bring it all back, in Kentucky, once one is convicted of a felony, you would not be allowed to vote again unless the governor signs an executive order like we saw yesterday. So this morning we're asking you, should people convicted of a felony be allowed to vote? You can do that right now in our Creme 2 mobile app. 50% of you are saying yes, 50% of you are saying no. It's still early, only 5 o'clock this morning. So it's a conversation that people are talking about, and you can definitely join in.
All right, Dana Marie, thank you. Well, so they say, 9 in 10 Americans don't trust drivers on the roads in the wintertime. According to a survey of 2,000 Americans, 91% of drivers don't have faith in other drivers as the temperature drops and the roads get slick. And almost a quarter of people even avoid riding with a friend or family member during the winter because they don't trust their driving. Okay, so what would you do for a lifetime supply of snacks? Well, according to a study from New York, a sixth of Americans would completely shave their head in exchange for a lifetime supply of snacks, and 18% said they would give up all of their electronic devices for 1 month. The average American will spend nearly $30,000 on snacks in their entire lifetime. $30,000?
Oh,
you could go buy a car.
I would totally do it. I would give up technology for a month.
I would give up technology. I would not shave my head. No, but technology is so worth it. We all need some type of...
A lifetime supply?
right. your whole rest of your life for
That's
just
true.
A month without your phone?
All right, we're going to put a poll up on Up With Krem Facebook page and let us know.
Let us know what you think. It's also our editor Eric's birthday. He loves snacks. I found out yesterday. Donuts, chips. We have all the chips this morning. So
yeah,
healthy to
flavors.
Start off our Friday morning. Okay, well, 5:09 now. A self-driving car could deliver your next grocery order. We connect the dots after the break.